He is Groot. Hail, Groot.
Hey, how's my favorite tree?
I am Groot.
It almost said, sound like he said, I am good. One day I'll understand you.
One of these days, you and I are going to be able to have a conversation.
I am Groot.
There's not a learn to speak Groot class I can take, is there?
I am Groot.
Well, this has been a lively and fascinating conversation.
I am Groot.
Hi, Groot.
I am Groot.
I'm worried about Rocket.
You think Rocket's gonna be okay? I'm worried about him.
I am Groot.
Well, I'm gonna, go. Now.
I am Groot.
Fascinating.
Hi, Groot. Me again. Well, I'm gonna, go. Now.
I am Groot.
Anything else?
I am Peter.
I am Groot.
Well, I'm gonna, go. Now.
I am Groot.
Does he say anything different? Let's see.
I'm back.
I am Groot.
Well, I'm gonna, go.
I can't skip.
Now.
I am Groot.
I'm back.
I am Groot.
Okay, he's done.
Well, I'm gonna, go. Now.
I am Groot.
He is Groot. Yeah, I can't pull the string anymore. There's nothing else happens. Let's go talk to Raccoon then. See, I thought there was like something else in this hall, but I guess not. Oh wait, there is. Piles of junk. Must look at.
You open your home to a bunch of misfits, and what do you get? Slobs. Peter, that's what you get.
No more of a slob than you are. The place was a pigsty when you just had it. More piles of junk.
Wait, wait. Shouldn't these parts be in the ship or something?
Hmm. Hope they're not that vital. Yeah, that's it. Okay. I am Rocket.
Hey, Rocket.
Hi, Quill.
I'll leave you alone.
Later, Quill.
You kidding me? All this thing he wanted to talk more, we would go to the engine room. And, he doesn't have anything to say. Man. Holy, 27 frames per second. What? I know, on the bridge. I'm headed to the bridge. Wait. Oh, monitor.
Carbon emissions are good. Engines are all running smooth. Some funky red light is blinking. Meh. That's probably fine.
Alright, let's go up to the bridge. News up here. Drax should be up here. Talk to.
Don't touch that. I gave you this ship. Or at least I think I did. I can barely recognize it now. Look at all this crap you added to her.
Yeah? You sound so proud.
Drax.
Hey, Drax. You doing all right?
When Thanos was alive, I was a warrior with a singular purpose. But now, I am useless. The others have made that very obvious to me. Maybe I should have seen it sooner. I was ordered to stay here while you and Gamora fought Hala. Even then, You no longer needed me.
I want you around.
Don't say that. I still want you around, Drax.
Thank you, Quill. I hope I do not squander your companionship. Clearly my skills, they are no longer as helpful as I had hoped.
You should try talking to the others. You know, maybe they can teach you something new, help you find a new purpose.
Who would you suggest? I don't know. I do not think any of them would want to.
Groot. Gamora, she knows how to focus.
Go talk to Gamora. She'll teach you to focus. And she's no stranger to the whole changing your purpose abruptly thing.
True.
Yes. His focus would be good. I will speak with her.
I should get going.
Star-Lord.
Yeah?
You still seem troubled by the visions of your mother.
Well, they keep happening.
I am here to comfort you about such matters. Unless you do not wish to speak of it.
I don't understand them.
I just don't know what they mean. But I want to find out. More than anything.
If I had visions of my family, there is little I would not do to discover the truth.
Thanks for checking in on me, Drax.
We are friends. I believe that is what friends do.
You got that right.
Drax will go learn from Gamora. Hopefully Gamora doesn't mind that, because we've been screwing around, screwing up everything with her. After this, no free rides for Rocket. Bridge console? I can go console first. Nothing here, right? Let's check out console. We get to check emails and stuff like that. Codex. Drax's family. From the way he talks about them, Hovat and Camaria were Drax's whole world. He even named his blades after them. Thanos killing Drax's family is what transformed him into the revenge-obsessed force of destruction he is today. I gotta admit, it's hard to imagine Drax as a dad, or a husband for that matter. Update on Drax. I thought Drax would be happier with Thanos dead, but something seems to really be bothering him. I hope he's okay. Earth. Last time I was on Earth, Michael Jackson's Bad was burning up the charts. It's probably only gone downhill from there, so I haven't really bothered to go back. No matter where I am, though, I'll always be home. Gamora. Well, there's no update here. I sure I read all this stuff in Chapter 1. So if you guys want to pause. Groot. Update. Note to self. Don't get him drunk. The bathroom will never be the same. Halfworld. Rocket doesn't talk about his past much, but when he does, it's not exactly uplifting. I know it involved being experimented on, but whenever I ask about it, he changes the subject. Now he wants to use the relic, but who is he trying to bring back? See, I'm not sure if it was called a Halfworld, but I know that the High Evolutionary was a character, or like, I don't know, he was originally a man, and then he got some kind of power, and I'm not sure how it all happened. But anyway, all his entire world, which may or may not be called Halfworld, is filled with basically anthropomorphic animal beings, like Rocket, just of all different animals. Hala. The Accuser. Planet of origin, Hala. Okay, she named herself after her own planet. As far as I can tell, Hala is a Kree warrior roaming the galaxy in her ship, the Revenant. She's crazy powerful, or possibly just crazy, and seems to be really pissed, particularly at me. She's after the relic that I got from Thanos. She calls it the Eternity Forge. Well, she can't have it. Nowhere, right? We've seen this. We've been there, right? Located inside the head of a decapitated celestial, Nowhere is a mining colony full of some of the galaxy's most shadiest people, most notably us. We have a hideout here for many reasons. One, convenient spot for refueling and restocking in Milano. Two, great place to find military-grade weapons and weapons-grade booze. Three, it's inside a big old head. What's not to love? Meredith Quill. known alias as Mom. Planet of origin, Earth. What do I say? She was a cool single mom. Tough as nails, funny, great taste in music. Mom dying is proof that the universe can really suck sometimes. Miss you, Mom. Nebula. Update. I told Gamora to leave well enough alone with Nebula. After killing her beloved father, I think the Guardians are pretty high on her list of people to stab. Hopefully we can steer clear until she chills out. Yeah, we're supposed to be staying away from her anyway. Nova Corps. Update. Apparently the Nova Corps have tangled with Rocket more than a few times. Can't say I'm really surprised. Rocket. Update. What the hell? Thanos is finally dead, and now suddenly Rocket wants to leave the Guardians? On one hand, he's probably earned a break, but on the other hand, I don't know. Self. Yep. We've read that before. I don't know why. That's not updated. Thanos. Update. Seriously bad dude. At least he was until we killed him. Booyah. But seriously, I'm still sort of scared of him even though he's dead. Here's going to make a bargain with Mistress Death and come back. The Collector. Maybe we viewed this before we went to visit the Collector? I think we did. The name is Tanalir Tavan, the Collector, planet of origin unknown. Nowhere is full of shady people, but none of them are shadier than this guy. He has a museum that buys and sells anything of value. No idea where he gets all his money, but he's apparently got units like a beach has sand. Gamora doesn't trust him at all, but Rocket is all about that bank account. No debit. Kree. The Kree were a technologically advanced race of aliens that used to have one of the biggest empires in the galaxy. Think evil Romans with lasers instead of swords. These days they've been pretty MIA. I heard a rumor that something bad happened in their homeworld, and that there aren't many of them left, but I don't know anything for sure. The Revenant. Hela's warship. Packed full of dead Kree and staffed by a skeleton crew, she's converted it into a creepy floating tomb. It's definitely still got some serious firepower. I wouldn't want to be on the business end of that thing. The Milano. A customized M-ship that I inherited from Yondu and the Ravagers. The Milano is the Guardian's home among the stars. She's looking pretty gnarly right now, though. Crashing into a planet didn't do her any favors. Yondu. Do we have an entry on him? Name Yondu Udanta. Known affiliations, the Ravagers. Planet of origin, Centauri 4. Leader of the Ravagers. Pretty much a scumbag. I don't know if or how Mom knew this guy, but he abducted me after she died and made me into his ship's little first mate, aka the designated toilet scrubber. I ran off as soon as I was old enough to go solo, and I try to avoid him as much as possible. Yeah, so now he's on our ship. Okay, so messages. Yondu. Subject, never again. So he writes like that as well. PD, I ain't too pleased with the mess you and your crew left all over my safe house. Dead levees and forever everywhere. You know my Ravagers got allergies they're very particular to. This is the final time I stick my cry out for you. Tell Gumanda I'm very available. Does he mean Gamora? Yondu. Vili? Subject, the state of our deal from Vili. Greetings, valued business associate. We thank you for your recent cooperation. The Collector is rather impressed with the specimen you have offered, despite the extensive damage you managed to do to it. He plans to display it prominently in his exclusive VIP lounge. Do not expect an invitation, as it is not open to the public at this time. Please do not hesitate to contact us again should you find yourself in possession of anything of interest to the Collector in the future. Sincerely, Vili, Curator of the Collector's Museum. Oh, we got something from Howard the Duck. Hello, hello. Wog? Star-Lord, you and Rocket haven't been returning my calls. What's the matter? Beverly says I need to expand my social outlets because I'm driving her batty, but nowhere ain't no place for a foul to make friends. Let's head out for escargot soon. Capiche? Howard. That's too funny. Groot. Forward, forward, share with those you axio unify. So he just forwarded. This is a way for him to communicate with us. He's not speaking, right? Or even writing it. Once there was a Contraxian and a Formalhati. Oh, the Formalhati are weird freaking things. They're basically like the amoebas or something like that. Once there was a Contraxian and a Formalhati that grew dependent on a symbiotic access to refracting spatial contingencies. Each cycle, the Formalhati would axio-unify the Contraxian near Pumar. However, the Formalhati never suspected that the Contraxian could acknowledge it as something other than the sentient, multicellular, gelatinous entity that it was. This went on cycle by cycle for eons. Never was it more than a harmonic, psionic resonance until fate stepped in. Without warning, Celestials punished the Contraxian and the Formalhati by... Jody? I think we got a... That's the letter next to H. I think we got a typo here. By implanting a cosmic egg into their homeworlds, ultimately destroying all life on those planets upon the birth of a new Celestial. Never, ever wait to speak your feelings. Share this with five you would axio unify. Yeah, it's basically the whole premise of this, basically this out-of-universe, Marvel Comics story called Earth-X. It's a limited series, and basically it takes place in the future, and so many heroes are dead. There are new ones. There's ones who became villains, vice versa. And, they find out at some point that there's an egg with a Celestial that's going to hatch and destroy the Earth, something like that. Blessings from numinous experience, your full potential. Okay. Universal Church of Truth. Alert, the following message has been flagged as spam. Hopefully I haven't read this one before. Holiest of greetings to you. Last year was a most faithful and rewarding year for the Universal Church of Truth, as we continue to share the truth with even the filthiest and most undeserving non-believers across the galaxy. But not everyone wants to hear the truth. Some non-believers even react with violence and commit horrible acts, such as killing our cardinals and destroying our temple ships. To continue our mission, we rely on the generosity of donors such as yourself across the galaxy for funding. Will you be one of those donors this year? Will you help share the truth? Even a donation of 10 units a lunar cycle can make all the difference. I believe the Universal Church of Truth. Nova Headquarters. Peter Quill / Surviving Guardian. Status report requests. Removal of criminal record. This is an official inquiry as to the status of your team following the recent engagement with Thanos the Mad Titan. There are many conflicting reports circulating as to what exactly happened. Transpired on the Kree planet. Please let us know whether you're still alive at your earliest convenience. Regards, Nova HQ. Cosmo. Lost jacket. Comrades, one of you leave your jacket at bar after cards. If you are having jacket deficit, this may be your jacket. Uvazenium. Cosmo. From Rocket. Cos. Might be mine. Red. 19mm spanner in the pocket. From Pip. Pip is one of Adam Warlock's friends. Yep, there's a smart move. Asking the dog what color the jacket he found is. Pip. P.S. Cosmo, your caps lock is stuck again. I might have read that one. I remember that. You guys can pause if you want. There's Yondu again. Let's call the Nova Corps, can we?
Nova Corps. Star-Lord? I'm afraid the Nova Corps has you blacklisted. A failure to cooperate, illegal disposal of a Class E volatile object.
Not Thanos?
What?
Look, we know you had Thanos' body. Now, I don't know what you did with it, and for your sake, I won't ask. Right? A little solid there. But you can expect no further help from the Nova Corps.
Damn.
Goodbye. And good luck.
So dramatic there at the end. This can be a busy signal. Oh, I could warn the collector. Yeah, let's warn the collector.
Collector's Museum, the collector is out at... Oh, Star-Lord?
Veely, listen. You need to lock up and get to safety.
I don't understand.
Secure Thanos' body. His daughter Nebula is headed to your location right now.
Yes, right away. Thank you.
Hopefully that'll help. Alright. I'm just getting up to sit back down again.
Heads up, everyone. We're going to Halfworld.
Stay out of trouble. I may not be so accommodating next time.
Yeah, huh?
And take care of the Milano. She's a ship, not a trash can.
Take care of yourself.
Take care of yourself, Yondu.
I always do.
Yeah, remember that.
Bye, Gamonda.
Gamonda. That was the one he was talking about.
Hala has found us.
And this is what we call great timing.
Why is it great timing? Halfworld. Abandoned lab. So when, now that we have this thing, everyone's going to want to bring everyone back, and that's the problem. Can't just resurrect everybody. Can you imagine?
What is this place? Home.
But disturb the balance of the universe.
I haven't been back here since...
Who are we here for?
Rocket, I need you to tell me what we're doing here. Who are you trying to resurrect? Lila.
Lila.
Come on.
Who's Lila? Here, let me help you.
Rocket, let me help you.
Don't touch her!
Touchy? Who'll remember that? Rocket or Peter?
Rocket?
Hey. Eternity Forge, activate. Form
Subject
of...
Subject seems to be responding well to the program.
A flashback.
Vital signs are good. Still no rejection of the artificial vertebrae or neural implants.
Was that a drill?
The only one who wasn't a total failure. Everything rests on you, my little friend.
He's a P-13? Oh, boy, watch out. Very high telepathic ability. Sorry, that's Babylon 5.
Rocket. You okay? I heard you screaming in there.
You little otter?
These walls aren't exactly soundproof. Not that he cares.
I'm gonna hurt that guy.
That guy. Ugh, just want to bite him in his stupid little face.
Try that once. It did not end well. Tasted terrible, too. So, did you get it?
Please?
You mean this? Wait, it's the right one, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it.
Is that some kind of USB adapter?
Once the computer's finished, we can finally break out of here.
Oh, that's that thing he had.
Advanced security. Supposedly unhackable blast doors. Piece of cake, right?
You sound worried.
She's P-14.
Hey, you can do this. Just stick to the plan. It's gonna work.
I won't let you down.
I won't let you down, Lila.
I know. Catch!
What we got?
Nice. You're making this look way too easy.
Tracking chip
Power
or something?
Power source. Designed by yours truly. Okay. Moment of truth. Go ahead and hook it up to the underside.
I'm gonna blow this thing. Ah! Ouch.
Stupid piece of junk.
You know your ear twitches when you're frustrated, right?
Hmm.
It's cute.
Stop joking and help me.
Yeah, hilarious, Lila. You mind helping me out?
Come on, you don't need my help.
Why do you keep doing that with your face?
It's called smiling. You should try it sometime.
Happy?
Oh, God. That was an actual smile. Don't get shocked this time. Click.
Now, all I need is a display and we're in business.
Mm. Okay. Just pull that out, huh? That easy? So it's gonna be sad because she's obviously gonna die during this. At the end of this.
Yes! Now we just sync it to the facilities network.
They just wanna be free, damn it.
Having that dream.
Still?
I'm outside again, in the fresh air somewhere. It's warm, bright. Can't hear a thing except the river rushing by.
Termination. Oh, that's her.
It felt so real. I can barely remember. It's been so long. But in this dream, I don't know. I'm almost there.
You have to get out of here.
We gotta focus, Lila. We have to get out of here, now!
You're right. We have to get these cages open.
There should be a hallway just outside that door. From there, we make a break for the main entrance.
Guess I should've warned her.
When I get out, I'm gonna find that place. And I want you to come with me. We'll find the river. I know it's gotta be out there. Will you come with me?
Count me in.
I'm going wherever you're going, lady.
We'll find home somewhere.
Aww. Not gonna remember it for long. Here they come.
Hide it, quick!
Good spot.
Subject 89P14. Still no progress. Begin prepping lethal injection.
No! And he looks at us. Or at Rocket, rather. If that's the high evolutionary, I am very disappointed.
I can't lose you.
I won't let them hurt you.
I'm not letting him do anything to you. You understand?
How are we supposed to stop him? Can we use that device?
Lila! Lila!
Damn it. Why is it opening? Is it gonna terminate me too? Press the keys. Oh, E. E. Q. Access granted. Yeah, what the hell? I wasn't supposed to be terminated. Bust that hunk of junk. Nice. Run!
We gotta move.
Wait.
What are you doing? Come on!
Get her.
Lethal injection.
No.
Oh.
Thought maybe I'd make it. Slower than I thought.
You sure?
Are you sure they got you? Maybe it's just a scratch or something.
I was there, Rocket. I know what it is.
There you are! Kill them!
No, don't kill them. You're gonna inject her lethally and then kill her?
I'll create a distraction.
Bit of an overkill,
don't you
think?
Now you're trying to get out. I can still cause a little chaos before it kicks in for good. I might as well try to take a few of them down with me, right? You go, Rocket. They'll be sorry for what they did to us.
I won't leave you to die.
No, no, you're not dying. I won't let this happen.
Please, don't make this any worse than it has to be. Survive, Rocket.
Oh no, closing the doors. Time to go.
Go! You need to get out! Now!
Of course you know she dies and he lives because this is a flashback.
I'm not asking you again! If you're gonna run, run!
Carry her out
of the lab. You can't do that carrying me!
Come on! We can't!
Hell, I can't!
Both of us!
Rocket, please!
I've got you!